One of the sixth standard students is sitting before me. His name is Ashral. And hi, Ashral.
Hello, sir.
How are you?
Fine, sir.
Are you watching the videos?
Yes, sir.
Very good. And don't forget to give comment.
Okay, sir.
Because that's your attendance.
Okay,
I remember that who is watching and who is not watching. If you give a comment in the comment section only, I will understand that you are watching the video. Yes, now in this video, we have been talking about a chapter in science, that is habit. Do you know fact given in the science textbook? That matter I will read and go further. Then I will go to explain different other concepts of this chapter. Okay, Ashrit?
Yes,
and
sir.
Do you know there is some matter given and I will explain. See that. Cactus, acacia, aloe vera. Aloe vera plant, like, you know, kalabanda in Telugu, that we call as kalabanda. You know, plants do not need water like chili or jasmine plants. Why? You know?
Because they are desert plants.
Very good. They are desert plant. And they are called desert plants. Yes, that matter is given here. Next, we can see camel frequently in the desert. What are the animals that we frequently see in deserts?
Camels.
Camels. Only camels we see. I don't know other animals also live in the desert except camel. I know only camel lives in desert. Yes? Yeah, desert plants and animals are suited to dry conditions. You know, desert area is completely dry area.
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And also vast temperature differences. Vast temperature differences, you know. There is a vast difference in the temperature. Okay?
Sure.
And next, different characteristics in the desert to make up desert habitats.
You know, sandy dust.
You know, but what are the different characteristics of, you know, what are the different characteristics in desert?
Dry sand.
Dry sand, very good.
Sandy dust.
Sandy soil, okay, right.
Sandy
and
tornadoes.
It's very dusty area.
Dusty tornadoes.
Tornadoes sometimes you see, yes, etc. No water is available there, you know.
Yes, sir.
And if water is available in desert areas, and what do we call that, you know? You know, there is a term, water in desert.
Cactus, sir.
No, water in the place where water is available in deserts. Oasis, some word is there, no? Oasis.
Yes.
Oasis. What is oasis? Oasis is the place where water is available in desert, I think.
Yes, sir.
I know that. Okay.
Oasis.
Oasis, right? Okay, that's different matter. That we don't need here, but different characteristics in the desert make up a desert habitat, you know, make up desert habitat. See, you know, the plants, you know, like cactus, acacia, aloe vera, these plants get water only in rainy season.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and you know, after rainy season is gone, you know, the water that collects in rainy season is stored
in the parts of the plant.
You know, like cactus leaves you take. The leaves are very bulged leaves, you know, and even acacia also, aloe vera leaves also, if you see them, the leaves are very bulged. And why are the leaves modified like that? Because they are collecting water only in rainy season and storing in the leaves.
For
future use. Future use in the sense, till the next rainy season comes. Till the next rainy season comes. You know, and what are other seasons there? Winter and
summer.
So during the seasons, they don't get water. There are no rains in this season. So that uses the stored water for the survival of itself in the desert. Okay? That is about this matter. Okay? This is only for our understanding, that this is just general understanding matter. Okay, this is the matter that what we have to discuss in this video. Ashrit, diversity of habitats in Telugu states. What are Telugu states?
Andhra Pradesh and Telangana state.
Very good. Andhra Pradesh and Telangana state. So, Diversity of habitats in Telugu states. What is diversity? Diversity means it's different. What are those different habitats? Let us see here. The plants that grow in coastal regions. There is no coastal region in Telangana, you know. Where are coastal regions present?
Present
in Andhra Pradesh only. You know, Vishakhapatnam. That Kakinada. You know, that is the border of the country, you know. Border of the state.
Yes, sir.
And out of that land body, then what is there? Ocean.
Oceans.
Seas and oceans there, no? Okay, of course, whatever it is. But there is completely water present. That is coastal regions, you know, different from those of Telangana state. Those regions are different, okay? The plants grow there, you know, what are the, can you name some plants grow in coastal regions?
Mangoes, I know only the coconuts.
Very good, coconuts. Yes, coconuts. Yes, coconuts are exported from the coastal regions, you know. In Telangana, most of the coconut vendors, you know, coconuts, some people sell coconuts here. They import from Andhra Pradesh coastal regions, you know, Anakapalli, Bellampalli, Kakinada, Vishakhapatnam, you know, these are all the areas, coastal areas of the state, and we import, you know, we means the Telangana people import these coconuts from that area. So here, why are these people importing those plants from there, those coconuts from there? Because that habitat suits which habitat? Coastal habitat. Coastal regions are suitable for growing crops like coconuts, mangoes, etc. Okay, here in Telangana, this habitat, this zone is, this region is not suitable for growing that crops. Okay, next, even Rayalaseema also. Not only Telangana, even Rayalaseema also. Next, we can see mangroves only in coastal districts. Mangroves, what are mangroves? These mangroves are a kind of plants grow where river and oceans meet. The plants grow there, mangroves, you know. River and oceans meet. In that area, some type of plants grow there. The plants are called mangroves. Okay, students, now grapes are grown in Telangana. Similarly, we can see same type of plants in all places of our state. Yeah, some same type of plants like, you know, grapes. Grapes are grown in Telangana. Mostly grapes are grown here. Okay, next. Let's move forward. Yeah, here there is a small discussion with your friends. Discuss with your friends and write. What you have to discuss and write? Do animals change their habitat?
Yes, sir.
How do they change their habitat? Plants always grow in a particular place.
Yes, sir.
But plants do not change their habitat. Okay, their seeds may be dispersed from one place to another. But plants are always stationary.
Okay.
They cannot move from the place where they are. Okay? Remember that. Next, what about our domestic animal? Have their habitat changed? Yes, of course. Our domestic animals change their habitat from one house to another house.
Yes.
Okay? Yes. Next, have you seen some birds in our surroundings only during a particular season? Why do they so? Have you seen some birds in a particular season? In your surroundings, only during a particular season. Have you seen a particular bird in a particular season?
Yes, sir.
When monsoon starts, you know, that cuckoos make sounds and, you know, I noticed that a particular observation.
Peacocks
also come out and they make some sounds. Okay? And even some insects, some locusts, like in hot summer season, you see some sounds of some creatures in roadside, that creaking sound, that it very embarrassed sound that we do not bear, we cannot bear that sound, you know, that kind of sounds we see, we hear only during summer season, you
crickets.
Know, like crickets, very good, okay, and because why do they so, why do we see them in that particular season, because that season, that particular season stimulates them to make that kind of sounds and that kind of to come out from their natural habitat and to make some sounds there. And then next, can we see all types of birds throughout the year?
Yes, sir.
No. What is your answer? We cannot see all types of birds throughout the year. We hear songs of cuckoos only in particular season. I already said no. Yes. We see cranes where? On trees in rainy season.
Yes, sir. In
the lakes. Yes. Where do they come from and where do they go at other times? They go somewhere where the food is available.
Yes, sir.
Where the living place is suitable for them, okay, where that optimum conditions for their survival available, okay, where they get the optimum conditions for their survival, we have to say like this, where their, you know, where the optimum conditions for their survival, they move to that place and live there, and again they come to our surroundings, okay, we see them. Next. Next, good habitat, good life. Students, what is good habitat?
Good habitat.
Yes,
good habitat
tell?
Is a good place to live.
Very good.
It's a comfortable
the place.
Place.
Ah, very good. That's very comfortable place for survival. Suppose the doors of our house are destroyed somehow. How will you feel?
Yeah.
You feel some fear. Yes, why? We fail to accept even little change in our house or surroundings. Okay, we never accept little changes in our house or in our surroundings because we feel disturbed. Because we feel
disturbed.
Okay, and do we feel the same way for others?
Yes, sir.
No, some people they don't feel the same. Some people they, you know, destruct the habitat of some other animals. Huh?
Yes, sir.
So, some of the people like you may feel the same, but some people they do not feel like the same. Okay. Next. We are dumping wastes in nearby ponds, lakes, rivers and grounds and destroying forests on a large scale to set up industries. Yes, to set up industries we are destructing forests. Think what will happen if all the organisms living in these areas, think what will happen to all organisms living in these areas, if we go on destructing their habitats, what will happen? They come into our houses.
And
the best example you can see in summer, tigers coming onto them. And during the lockdown, you know, as there were no human beings roaming or running vehicles on the roads, the roads which go through the forests, They came into the cities following the road.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
To make a habitat.
Yeah. And even if you destruct their habitat, that means if you cut down the trees, the animals like tigers, lions living in the forest, they come into our houses. What will be the result of this? That what I said, you know, that animals come into our habitat and disturb us. Okay, don't we depend on different organisms? Of course, we depend on different organisms. You have already studied about the independence of different organisms. You have already studied about independence of different organisms. You know, only human beings need independence, all other organisms also need independence, right?
Yes, sir.
Right, and try to give your answer on the basis of that. What? All other organisms also need independence. Okay? If we harm them, wouldn't we be harmed as well?
Yes, sir.
Yes, we would also be harmed as well if we harm them. Think how a good unharmed habitat leads to a better life for us. Unharmed habitat, you know, unharmed habitat in the sense our house is unharmed habitat.
Yes, sir.
Our house is what? Unharmed habitat. Because we have doors, we have windows, we have, you know, comfortable bed to sleep, and we have food, we can cook and eat in the house, you know, right? And then this is very unharmed habitat of human beings. And in the same way, other animals also have their unharmed habitat of their own. Okay, you know what is that? Different kinds of birds come from long distances like Kolleru and Pulikot lakes of Andhra Pradesh state. Yeah, what are the lakes present in Andhra Pradesh state, Ashrit?
Kolleru and...
Loudly.
Kolleru and...
Pulikot. Lakes are present in Andhra Pradesh. And you know, different birds come from long distances. Okay, during the months of when? During the months of October to March. And pelicans appear near those lakes. Pelicans are also some sort of creatures. They appear where? Near those lakes, in those seasons. Next, in Kurnool district, you can see a bird called Battameka Pitta.
Battameka Pitta.
You know that? Battameka Pitta, which flies over long distances to come here. Where? To the lakes in Andhra Pradesh. What are the names of the lakes?
Kolleru
and Pulikot lakes. Yes. And generally we can see birds flying over long distances to find suitable conditions to reproduce. So birds reproduce their generation, and they generally what? They fly over long distances to find what? Suitable conditions to reproduce. And animals like turtles and fish also move from place to place. Turtles also move from one place to another for their survival. And also some kinds of turtles move away from coasts of West Bengal. From coasts of what? From coasts of West Bengal and Orissa to coasts of Visakhapatnam. The turtles move from long distances from there. Next, have you heard about the pulasa fish?
No, sir.
No. Gather information about them. Pulasa fish. You just Google it and you will get information about pulasa fish. And how and why do they change their habitat in some seasons?
Okay,
this is the project work that you have to do. And you just write in your notebook and present it in our WhatsApp. Okay, and there are some keywords given, students: habitat, terrestrial and aquatic. Only three keywords are given in the textbook. And if you have any doubts related to this video, please give a comment in the comment section, and that will be your attendance as well. You have to give a comment compulsory. Okay, and I hope you all understood video. Thank you for listening, and thank you one and all. Till here the lesson is completed, and in the next video I will teach you about improve your learning section of the chapter. Improve your learning section is here. You know, improve your learning section is here. This is the list of questions. Okay, I will give you answers for these questions in the next video, students. Thank you for listening, and thank you one and all. See you. Thank you.